So we're going to come back with the Nintendo 64 because that was my entire childhood nostalgia. We'll go ahead and hit these best multiplayer games. I'm going to do a top 10 on this one. With an honorable mention, I got to have those. Gauntlet Legends, it was our arcade game. It was fun. The catchphrase, food is good, would never get old. Those power-ups. Number 10 on my list, and it's probably number 5 or 4 on other people's list, is Mario Party, which is a hell of a fun game. But you had to have 4 people. You don't have 4 friends there, the computer will cheat. All right, that is the concept. It's true. They would cheat you. You will not get no dice rolls. But when you got 4 people and you playing Mario Party, that is a party, okay? Number 9, Battle Tanks. It's tanks, man. You're blowing each other up, but they got different models. They got heavy tanks, small little light tanks, in-between tanks. Each one had their own little special. If you play with the big boy tank, I mean, you get automatically started off with a nuclear warhead. So imagine those games when everybody got a nuke and you just trying to drop it in somebody's base. Still the Queen Lord. Me and my friends had hours of play with this game. So it gets that number 9 spot. Next one, I don't know how many people remember it, but Vigilante 8 was like the Nintendo 64 version of Twisted Metal. Cars driving around a battlefield, each one with different guns and weapons, and you're trying to destroy each other, different power-ups. It's just good times, man. With some hot chips and Cactus Cooler, and we good. Number 7. Cruising the World. I wasn't the biggest fan of Cruising USA. I don't know why. Don't ask me, because I couldn't give you an answer. But Cruising the World did everything right. Custom, all them cars, all the cars you wanted to drive in your whole entire life. And we are still out here buying Civics, racing around the world. For some reason, our cars could do backflips on this game and tricks. I don't know why. It was just good racing fun. Number 6 on the list is one of my favorites. It's just Star Fox. The reason why it's lower down the list is because after you master the controls on Star Fox, the barrel roll, and I don't know if it has an official name. People call it different things. We used to call it the get back, which it was just a quick little move to do a flip around and jet back the other way when somebody was on your tail. But this came with when you got the double lasers or you got that bomb attack. It's just good fun. 4 people trying to have dogfights in the air. So number 5 on my list, it could be higher. This is Perfect Dark. Perfect Dark had a excellent single player mode that was great storyline, but multiplayer took it up a notch. You could 4-on-4. It had similar guns to GoldenEye, but it was more futuristic. And you also was added on bots. So not only could you play against your 4 friends, but you can add about 8 bots onto the board too. And you can make those bots either weak or you can make them hell of hard. Sweet little guns like the laptop gun that you could throw onto the wall and make into a gun turret was highlights. You also couldn't play it without the expansion pack, so you had to go buy that expansion pack for your system. Because at this point, we needed to go to PlayStation 2, Xbox, GameCube with some more graphics, but they were still trying to push out state-of-the-art games. So that's number 5 on the list. Number 4, and this is the hard one, because I had to choose between the 4 great wrestling games that came out for the Nintendo 64. It started off with WCW versus NWO Revenge, World Tour. And I remember that was the game that me and my best friend, we saw that game and we was like, yeah, we got to go cut some freaking grass and get this money up because we need this game in our life. We was huge wrestling fans. WCW was on the upcome right there. I think it might have been pushing out WWF at the time. I know they're E now, but whatever. But the game that wins the number 4 spot is WrestleMania 2000. I know a lot of people would say, oh, No Mercy is the game. That's the one for the WWE. Yeah, I would too, but by that point, that was the end of the console, and they were just trying to push out way too many graphics for the console, so I felt like it was a little sluggish, whereas WrestleMania was smooth. It was almost, it was a little bit smoother than WCW versus NWO Revenge, which is excellent. And this gave you the same custom creative characters. You can make kind of custom matches, your own belts on it, and it was just good fun. Number 3 on the list, I'm gonna go with Super Smash Brothers. I know you guys are waiting for it. Smash Brothers is everything you wanted in a game because it took all your favorite characters from Nintendo and they put them in one game. You had Kirby, you got Link, you got Princess Zelda, Princess Peach, Mario, Luigi, Bowser. You name it. If it's a Nintendo game, they threw it in there, and it's four on four for the win on stage, and everybody's knocking each other out. I mean, this is hours of gameplay. You got people still around the world who think they're the best at it. Every console generation afterwards had to have this game on it in some form or fashion. It's a staple. Number two, and I know you're thinking, like, what's better than Super Smash Brothers? It's Mario Kart 64. Honestly, that's just one of the best kart racing games. They had a clone, which was Diddy Kong Racing. I think Diddy Kong Racing was like probably, what is it, like the sixth highest grossing game on the console. Well, Smash Brothers was the fifth highest grossing, and Mario Kart 64 was the second highest grossing game on the console, period. That lets you know that it was the staple. To this day, as a grown-up, if you bring this game up, people are going to argue about who's the best and, you know, who their character is. A lot of people like to use Toad. Some people like heavier people like Bowser and, you know, Wario to knock people off the map. And everybody knows with that damn dreaded blue shell, if you first place and you the damn last place person who ain't got no chance of winning is going to throw a blue shell and hit you right before you cross that finish line. Everybody hated getting a single damn banana and no help to you. But it's just, that was just goodness right there. Anybody who has siblings or actual real friends would know about this game. And number one on the list is GoldenEye 007, third highest grossing game on the console. This is first person goodness. Every game we play now, I mean, I know Doom and other things on the PC started off first person shooting, but this right here brought it to everybody's living room. To this day, everybody thinks that they're the best at this. You can challenge me whenever you want to. You're going to catch that RCP 90. You're gonna catch that. You're gonna catch them power weapons. You're gonna die. You can put it on one hit kill. You're gonna die. I'm just gonna let you know. I used to go to other neighborhoods, other city limits, just to go catch the hottest GoldenEye player and have the Molly Whop him. Okay, this almost caused a rift between me and my older brother. This is when he quit video games. I'm just gonna throw that out there. Like him and his whole crew, they couldn't hang. Okay. I had to put them out, put the pasture. They just stopped playing. You know, they went on to try to be adults, I guess. I don't know. So that's the best N64 games, man. You got nothing else for you? Geeks and Goons.